doing my own concert, well, two concerts in 1 year, it's something that I never really expected was going to happen, and I don't think anyone could have predicted that was going to happen, but yeah, it's safe to say I'm never going to forget 2018, and the story of that year is just, I still can't believe it went the way it did, and it has heavily impacted the way things have gone since then. So it was around May 2018, it was just after I did that Easter Disco performance, and I was thinking, you know, wouldn't it be great if I could do my own concert and perform on a stage to, like, yeah, a decent amount of people, not just doing Tragedy in 5, 6, 7, 8, a full on concert. And I went to see Steps in the back end of May at Dalton, and I was really, I thoroughly enjoyed that show. I remember seeing the intro, it was, and it opened with Summer of Love, and it was a really, like, summer-esque song, and it was like a festival sounding intro, and they had flags and all the colours and flares and everything like that, and I was like, this is something that I could maybe do myself. It's not as if it's hard, but it's something really hard that's going to be hard to incorporate. So then, as ideas started flowing more, I decided to contact the management team at school, and started getting talks about a concert, saying, you know, I'd love to do something like that. And then, yeah, it was just a case of picking the right date and making sure I could get the go-aheads and picking the right times, and it was all about picking the right audience as well, because my biggest fear was walking out on the stage and having, like, 10 people in the audience. So I wanted to make sure I got it right, and obviously it's hard to do something like that in school of all places, but the planning was stressful. But it was an experience, and it all led up to the big events. So then, as talk started spreading about the show, I got allocated a slot, and it was a half an hour show at dinner time, at lunch, and so it was important that I make sure I got the right amount of songs put in there, and the right songs picked, and making sure it would work well with the audience. And so once I picked the songs, I remember I opened with Summer of Love, went into Better the Devil You Know, then possibly 5, 6, 7, 8, Last One on My Mind's Better Best Forgotten, Love's Got a Hold of My Heart, One for Sorrow and Tragedy. So I put that all into the show somehow. I can't even remember much about it, to be honest. So then once I'd done that, I had to pick outfits, and I was thinking, well, who is my main inspiration for the show? Steps, of course. So I didn't have to, but what I wanted to do was base my outfits off them, especially since it was a Summer of Steps tribute concert, as the show was called, Summer of Steps. So I think it was appropriate that I base it similarly off the latest tour, the Summer of Steps tour that they were embarking on at that point. So then I got my outfits sorted, and honestly, you can ask people, my ideas for outfits, honestly, I'm so tight when it comes to buying stuff. Like, most of my outfits are all from Primark, and yeah, for all my shows, because I'm like, well, I'm only going to wear it once. So I remember I got a pink polo shirt from Primark for like £6, and that was what I was going to wear on stage. I got some skinny white jeans for £10, and that was like, that was literally like pushing past the budget. I remember I bought some sunglasses, and yeah, I think that was about it. I bought a lot of props. I have like ribbons and I have big flags, and I've literally still got all these to this day as well, all these props. I remember I got all them, and it was just a case of I got some hospital equipment as well for chain reaction. Yeah, chain reaction, deepest shade of blue. I did those as well. And then once I had all them, it was a case of putting it all together. And I had to rehearse myself, obviously, and get the show spot on. But it was weird because I'd never done anything like that back then. That was my first proper concert, and obviously I can't say that now, I've done many. But it was a case of, I'd never done anything like that before. All I'd done was have everything sorted for us, and just going over the top of the stairs on the street and doing tragedy, for example. So I had to make sure I was in contact with the right people at the right time, and got everything sorted. I remember it was really stressful though, trying to make sure everything was sorted, having to make sure all the outfits were sorted, all the planning, making sure I had time to rehearse as well, making sure tickets were sold. And it is a lot of responsibility trying to organise a show by yourself, especially in an environment like school. And it turns out I actually do have the outfits from the first ever concert. I'll show the camera as well. That's the outfit I had, and that's what I opened with. It was this pink shirt, and it only cost £6 for Primark. And it was quite a bold look to open with, because I came out in pink and white, which isn't exactly the best colour for, I'm sure you know what I'm going to say. But it's not exactly the best colour, but it works, and I have some sort of thing where everything I wear ends up working on stage. So, I mean, don't ask, but it did, okay? I remember I didn't really know what to expect at that point, because it was just, I was doing a show. But I mean, how am I supposed to know how things are going to go, because I've never done anything on that bigger scale before. And yes, it is just a half an hour concert at school, but it's still a lot of planning, it's still a lot of making sure everything works the way it's meant to. And yeah, I think it went really well. The planning was really difficult because it was really stressful, and a lot of the work was put on myself to make sure everything went like the way it could, as perfectly as it could have been. I can't remember how many people were there now, but the tickets were sold okay. We could have sold out a lot more. And I think it was £1 a ticket. I will have a ticket somewhere, but that'll be like locked away in some sort of storage unit, basically known as my glitter box behind the cupboard. So that's got all my stuff in, but we are not opening that. Change of plan, I went back into the box and I found the tickets for my first ever show. And it's just so weird looking back, guys. The number presents for Summer of Steps tribute performance, lunchtime, Monday the 16th of July as Assembly Hall. £1 admission, refreshments can be purchased. I remember all that actually, yeah. I remember getting all the tickets printed off, and it was just, you could buy ice cream and popcorn at the show as well. And it's so weird looking back, because it was already 2018, but it feels like ages away, but then it doesn't at the same time. But I think it was a great way to start the run of concerts that I had. It was a great one to begin with. So I've already mentioned the inspiration for the show, but I also did this for charity, which was the Meningitis Research Foundation, because it was in aid of Natalie Brown, who's my cousin, and she sadly passed away due to fighting meningitis back in 2001. So it was a great way for me to spread awareness whilst doing something close to my heart as well, and raising money. I think we raised of like £120 or something like that for charity, which is amazing, considering the tickets were £1, and obviously we had refreshments on sale. But yeah, it was great to do something, because it was my first concert, and it was also my first charity event as well. And I became quite well known for doing a lot of work for charity, as I'll mention later. But yeah, it was great, because I got to do something that I love whilst doing it for someone I love. And yeah, it went really well. And then the show itself was, I remember the actual show really well. I had the first two lessons off in the morning, or first three lessons to rehearse and do a full dress rehearsal and sound check. And I remember everyone started coming in at dinner time and there was people like queuing up at the door and everything like that. I remember, and I'm sure many of you still remember, that I had VIP tickets on sale and there was a whole front row was like designated for VIP ticket holders and they were £3 and you got obviously the priority seating, ice cream, popcorn. I think there was like a signed ticket by me or something like that, but honestly, it's just looking back, it's funny to look back, but it was also great because it's just something like that was done in school, which isn't really something that would have been predicted. But I remember the show really well on the actual day. And then as soon as the show began and the lights went down, and then Summer of Love started, and then there was flags on stage, and then I went on, and then started singing and dancing and doing my stuff. And I just remember it was a great feeling being on stage and having everyone cheering back to you, and having, obviously it's weird because at school not everyone's going to know the Stepstones, but then it also worked really well to perform live as well. Bit of a double, you know, had Devil Horns on, and yeah, that one went really well. I'm trying to remember which songs I did. I'm sure I did like a medley of Better, Best Forgotten, Last Time of Mine, 5, 6, 7, 8, closely followed by Deeper Shade of Blue, if I remember rightly. Obviously 5, 6, 7, 8, everyone knows, so that went down really well. And then obviously I had to end with Tragedy. And I did Chain Reaction in hospital outfits and everything. And Tragedy was my last song then, and that became some sort of pattern. I can never do Tragedy any other position than last song. And yeah, I mean, I wish there was a way to look back and see how the show actually went, because when you're on stage, you're obviously seeing one point of the show, but then everyone in the audience is seeing a different part of the show from a different point of the view, because obviously they're sat there watching you perform, and you're stood on stage with that all coming back. And I don't know which one's better, to be fair, because obviously I've been to concerts before, and I'm torn, because it is a great atmosphere being in the audience, but obviously being on that stage is amazing as well. Because you can just, like, yeah, you can't really put it into words how it feels to be on stage. It's a weird sense, like, you become a different person in a sense when you get on stage. Not to in a bad case, but yeah. And then the show ended, and the response after the show was just amazing. I remember the day after, and after the show, and everyone was just, like, oh, Dylan, you were absolutely amazing. I had such a great time. It was, yeah, we were clapping along the whole way. And it's very rare that someone gives you negative feedback after a show, but the way I am is I want the really constructive criticism, because if a show went really well, I'll know it did, and if people say it did, I'll be like, yeah, it did. But then if it doesn't go very well, or if I mess up, if someone says something, then that's great, because I can work on it, and that, yeah, does improve. And I also remember the response from the show was really good, and it really did give us a confidence boost. This was on the last week of school, so you can imagine everyone was alright in high spirits. And then I had a few days after that, and then it was the last day. And I remember I went to go and see Steps live at Newcastle Prize front row, which was kind of unexpected, but I did. And that show was just amazing. It was weird because I literally, 4 days beforehand, prior to the show, performed the exact same songs basically. And then they went to the exact same intro, and it's just like, you're literally watching thinking, yeah, they are definitely better than me. And, yeah, it was great just to be there, and it was just to have a bit of, what's the word, a break from everything. But, if you know me well enough, after a show, I'll start planning the next one straight after, and that's exactly what happened with this. So summer begun, and I was on a trip down to Oxford, and I was in the car, and I was thinking, right, I need to start planning what else I can do in the future, because obviously not that I needed to, but it was a case of I want to sort of achieve more. And I remember before the actual summer concert, I was on holiday in late June, and I was literally sat in the apartment all around the pool putting the show together, and people must have thought I was mad for wanting to do something so soon afterwards, but it's just once the show ends, I want to do it all again, and that's exactly what it is. So I was on the car down to Oxford, and I was like pitching ideas to myself, looking through my notebook, and thinking, right, what can I do next? What can I do to like make it bigger than what I did last time, because I still wanted to do a full 2-hour show like someone like Steps would do, and that's probably inspiration from going to see them live that day, like a few days beforehand. That probably didn't help. And I was, at first I was thinking of a Christmas show, and I was thinking that would be really good actually, if I have a good blend of Christmas songs and Steps songs. But back then it was always the case, I never thought I'd perform outside of school. I thought, yeah, I'll do that in school. And it's always, you have limitations and limits of what you can actually do, restrictions. Because in school it's not the same as outside of school. It's not as if it's easy for everyone to come and watch, and it's not as if people are going to want to come after school to see it either. So it was all trying to plan in moderation and making sure everything was sorted. And it was something that was actually could happen. That I could actually go to the head teacher and say, this is what I've had as an idea, would it be possible? And I remember some of the ideas I had were Grace and some of them were just a base naff, and I thought, I don't even know if this is for the best. I was thinking of doing the Steps in the Christmas show. And it was gonna, and I did have some good ideas for it, but it was just a case of, is it even gonna be possible at the same time? I was thinking it could be. And I was thinking I could have merchandise on sale to make some extra money. And I could take the money this time, and it was just, I was unsure about how it was going to go. Then I had the perfect idea around July, August sort of time. And I thought, wait, what if I did my own show outside of school and booked a venue? And I was thinking, oh, well, would people show up? That is a massive, massive risk, and I don't know if I want to take it. Obviously did some research and thought, what if I did it for charity? And sadly in August, my great-grandma passed away. And obviously that was a really emotional time for the whole family. And I thought, well, Marie Curie really helped him, so why didn't I do a charity in aid of a concert and have the charity in aid of Marie Curie? And that's what I decided to do. And then it was all the case of planning after that. Obviously I had ideas. And I thought, should I be adventurous or should I play it safe? And I decided to play it safe and do all Steps songs and do a big tribute concert. At that point, I was still known as Steps, the Ultimate Tribute. I wasn't known as Dylan Wood, like I am now. And then, so I started like, writing down ideas and thinking I could have a raffle as well, tombola. And then, obviously, I had to make sure my show was going to be amazing. And I had some great ideas. I was like, is this even going to be possible? And it was. And it's just amazing to think, literally, that time last year, I was doing the Christmas disco. Fast forward a year, and I was doing the full 2-hour show at the Thomas Wilson Club in Caithness. So, I think everything happened for a reason. So I had the idea for the show, and then all the plans started coming into place. But my main fear was, are people going to show up? And then more and more people started buying tickets, and I thought, you know what, people actually might show up. And obviously people had always been quite excited about it in school, so I thought, yeah, that's a big audience then as well. And then it was all the case of buying outfits for the show. After that, I remember I literally got replicas basically of a lot of the Steps outfits, or the nearest possible thing. I had my disco jackets, my cowboy jackets, and Scared of the Dark outfits. Wedding outfits and club outfits, and they were the main sections of the show. And I did have backing dancers at the show as well, which are my cousins, and they played a big role in making the show look as great as it did. So they came to Dance City quite a few times, and I had a choreograph them, because all the choreography was done by me, taken from Steps, and a lot of it I put my own touches on it as well. And I say I haven't had any dance experience, and I literally haven't, and this was like my chance to sort of show off what I can actually do. And yeah, a lot of it was all improvised by me, and that was the hard, and there was a lot of stress put on me because I wasn't just learning my routines, which I had to like try and get amazing at. It was also putting Steps, the dancers' choreography to my dancers as well, and get it all done in a matter of a few weeks, and making sure they had outfits and everything sorted as well, which a massive thank you to their family for sorting that out too. And it was great how the show all came together, but I was literally, my stress levels for that month, October through to November the 23rd, were just absolutely, like, sky high. I didn't really think that it was normal how high they were. Because you got to think, I was stressing about ticket sales, I was stressing about, you know, like obviously ticket sales, outfits, dancers, getting everything sorted. It was just a case of, how on earth is this all going to work? I had loads of problems with getting stuff sorted at the venue as well, and then having to get microphones and speakers and thinking stuff was going to work, and it didn't, because I was, yeah, and then eventually everything came together on the night, and it was just, it's, all that work went in, and it went really well. So if we look here, we've got the iconic disco jacket, and that's what I wore for Stomp, when I came on for Stomp, and then obviously here I've got the cowboy jacket, and that was used for 5678, the country and western section. And I remember, they literally weren't even that expensive, and it's just, I wanted to recreate something that Steps had done, and that was my way of doing it, by getting similar outfits. And I think it went really well, and those who went to the tour, the Party on the Dance Floor tour in 2017, will know why I picked those outfits, and who they're resemblant of, and yeah. I had a massive amount of help from family, because obviously it was a charity that was close to them as well. So they were responsible for a raffle, tombola, football cards, anything that got sold for the charity. Anything that was done on the night, that was a lot of that. Most of that was done by them as well. And I remember when I actually came to rehearsing for the show, I did all that at Dance City in Newcastle. And they kind of was used their space for rehearsals. And I was there for 5 or 6 times, and it was just, that was a great chance for me to actually learn and see what I was like dancing and then work on it and make sure I got the routine spot on. Then the actual show itself on the actual night, I remember there was a lot of people there, it was probably sold out near enough. And we managed to raise over £1,000 for Marie Curie, which is just amazing, thinking about all that, which is raised for that charity on that night. And then the show itself was great because it was just good to see it all come together and work so well. I remember the dancers started by reenacting the steps in rubber, walking through the audience with capes and masks on, which again I provided, and I think I still got the capes for it actually. Yeah. Here it is, the cape from the show. I'm not gonna unravel it because it's very big. But yeah, that's what was used for the dancers when they walked around with it on their heads and they had the masks on as well, and yeah, that's how it all works. And I remember Steps obviously a massive inspiration for us when I was planning the show, and obviously it worked really well because it wasn't as if it was all my own stuff. I could look back at videos like every night and say, right, this is what I need to work on and this is what I need to look like. So I'm going to go through the set list for the show, so brace yourselves and take a deep breath, well, me basically. Scared of the Dark, Deeper Shade of Blue, Chain Reaction, Happy. Then that was the first dark sinister section. Then it was in the disco, which was Stomp, which had a Voulez-Vous by ABBA interlude beforehand. In the a medley of Better Best Forgotten and Last on My Mind. Then No More Tears, Enough is Enough, mashup with No More Tears on the Dance Floor. Then Dancing with a Broken Heart. Then When I Said Goodbye. I can't really actually remember all this. Then I went off and then went to the country and western section, which was 5678, which had an amazing interlude by the dancers, who did like a sort of dance battle. Then Better the Devil You Know, which was a salsa remix. Then It's the Way You Make Me Feel, Heartbeat, Story of a Heart, which had a montage of Steps videos in the background. Then a medley of Summer of Love, Paradise Lost, Despacito, and then Summer of Love Reprise. And then I did a story about this actually. I did a dance like just after Summer of Love, and it wasn't as full on then. And I remember I was going over again, just dancing in my room casually, and I ended up dislocating my knee in September, just gone because I was doing that dance, and it was just, I think I made a swift movement, and my knee just went and I like fell to the floor, and it was just, oh, I'm very grateful that didn't happen on stage, but I'm not as bad as I was back then. That's probably why. Then after Summer of Love, I went into the club section, Neon Blue, which had an interlude with scenes from Newcastle on the Steps video. Then a big medley of Love You More, You'll Be Sorry After My Love Has Gone, and Let's Go Hold My Heart. Then the fake last song, which was One for Sorrow, and I love performing One for Sorrow because you just look around the audience and everyone's doing the One for Sorrow too bad, and everyone's doing it back. Because it's such an iconic routine, everyone knows this, and I think that's what really makes that the song it is. Then I went off, and then I had the big encore, which was Tragedy, of course. And it was all wedding themed, so I had the wedding outfits on, and everyone, it was all building up, and everyone was clapping along, and I had wedding scenes, and the bells were ringing, and the dancers were on stage doing, like, actions and that. And I think that was, now again, that was obviously taken from the Steps tour, but that was a great celebration at the end of the show to show how well it had actually gone, and it obviously tragedy for something that gets everyone up on the dance floor, and that was the case back then. The planning for the show was really challenging, shall I say. On the actual night I got there, but well, the afternoon was set up, and obviously the raffle had all been set up in the tambura, then it was my turn to make sure everything was planned, from speakers to microphone to outfits. And you've got to think, the doors open at 7, so I had like, I got there 3 or 4. That's like really a handful of hours to get everything sorted. And loads of stuff went wrong. I had no, the speakers weren't working. I took a mic and then they took it off us, and I had to try and get another mic quickly because my mic at home wasn't working properly. Then we had to get certain cables and had to rush off to get that. I got the outfit sorted quickly, I didn't have the time to do a full rehearsal. I had the support act, the mini mix, who were opening as well, and they had to start at 7:30. So they had to do a run through, and I had to get all the music set up from my perspective as well. And it was just, and I remember, it was just so, like, the amount of tension beforehand. For that week, the good week beforehand, was just, obviously it ended on a Friday, which is when I had the show. And it was just before last, and on the actual night, my stress levels were insane. Like, I'm surprised I didn't have a heart attack on stage, to be honest. Like, just imagine that much stress and then having to do a 2-hour show. And I remember that being done, and actually getting home on that night and thinking, oh my god, I cannot believe that is over. And I was over the moon. And it was a great time, and I remember the show was amazing, and it's great memories and all experience, but I was more than happy when it was over. Rehearsals for the show were great, because obviously a few weeks at Dance City, it was every Sunday if I remember rightly, I used to get to Newcastle, go to McDonald's, get a caramel iced frappe, and then go to Dance City and rehearse for 4 hours, then go and get a McDonald's afterwards as well. So to be fair, I wasn't really getting any fitter by doing that, but I remember that's how it all went, and it's so weird because obviously you're in the studio, and that's nowhere near the same as being on the actual stage, but I'd never been in a dance studio before, and it was like, this is literally the same sort of next steps with rehearsing, and it's all the realisation, it doesn't exactly hit you at that point, but I think it was after that show, the realisation hit us, how things are gone. I remember I had to get up after the show, like on Monday, for school, and I went to the front of the Yeager group, and I had to tell everyone how it went, and how much money I've raised, and it is like it's a bit daunting, but it's also like great at the same time. And everyone was like, "Oh, your show was amazing! I saw all the videos; it was great." And yeah, it was a great celebration and a perfect way to end 2018. It was Christmas 2018, and it was like school, and I had Christmas performances planned, which was very spontaneous, shall we say. I remember I tried to plan something, and it sort of went a bit, yeah, it didn't all work. And then we were in the school sort of nativity sort of performance, kind of, the carol service. And then I literally got told on the way out of the hall, when we're on the way to Christmas dinner, "Oh, are you okay to perform 3 songs?" And I was like, yeah, okay. So then I had to do a Christmas karaoke session, which went really well, but I did forget some of the words somehow to some of the Christmas songs. But that was a great performance because everyone was joining, everyone knew the words, but it was so last minute and spontaneous that I had no time to prepare whatsoever. So that one went well, and then I decided that I was going to do a 10-minute mega mix for Christmas on the last day, and I thought it was going to be like right at the end of the day. And again, I found out like 5 minutes before the assembly that it was going to be in 10 in the morning. I was like, oh no, I have not got the energy to do this. So I run up to the hall, quickly get changed, and then go over the mega mix that I literally put together the night beforehand. And that performance was probably the worst performance I've ever done in my entire life. From my perspective, probably the audience perspective as well. Because you gotta think, people didn't really only join in with Christmas songs at 10 o'clock in the morning. and I didn't really want to be singing Christmas songs in the morning. It's like when you see all these artists on This Morning, for example, and they're like performing, and you think, I feel so sorry for them. It was really me having to try and give loads of energy on stage 10 in the morning, which wouldn't have been the best result, not gonna lie. And I had to do like a lot of songs in the space of 10 minutes. And then the performance got cut short, the music was really quiet as well. And we didn't even have a mic to begin with, and I tried to find that as well. It was just such a, it was like the performance wasn't meant to be. It was alright, but it was just absolutely so awkward on stage, and then my voice got worse because of the loss, and I was like, oh no, what's going on? And then afterwards everyone was like, oh, you were amazing, Dylan, well done. And I was like, no, I wasn't, don't you dare say that. No, it was really good, honestly. But I don't mean people are going to say that. I just knew that the performance didn't go well. And then other ones, I know that did go well. I was like, after this, I just knew that it didn't go well. I was like, this better not have ruined anything, because it was just, let's just forget this never happens. And then, after that, I had a disco on the street at dinner. And then Tragedy in 5678 came on, so I had to dance to that as well. Except to say that Christmas was pretty much consumed by me. And that was great, doing Tragedy again, because everyone was joining in. And that was the perfect way to end, and it was nice to leave after school after that and think, yeah, I've had a good 2018. Because you've got to think, I had two concerts, and Easter disco, Christmas performance at Christmas dinner. I'm really grateful for how many opportunities I had, because my school have been really great and they've given us so many opportunities, and if it wasn't for them, then I don't really think I'd be in the position that I am at the minute. I think 2018 was a good time though, because my confidence had grown a lot in myself, and I knew that I was better than I thought I was, and I knew that I sort of had the potential to keep going and do other things, but nothing could have prepared me for the year ahead. 2019 was just, it's not the year I expected it to be. And that's a good thing, by the way. Obviously, the November show, Party on the Dance Floor at the Thomas Wilson Club, was a great experience, and it was just, after that, it was sort of, I wanted to give something back to people and say, as if to say a thank you for everyone, and obviously, I wanted to try and get some more experience at that point as well, so I decided to release my own documentary on DVD. It was Party on the Dance Floor live documentary. And a lot of people got the DVD, actually a lot of copies got sold, possibly 30 or something like that, but I remember they were sold for £5 each, and I basically covered the entire show and the whole plan. It was about half an hour long. And a lot of footage got recorded for that didn't get used, like that learn the dance steps and stuff like that. And I'm more than happy they didn't get used, and I don't think they're ever gonna see the light of day, not gonna lie. And it was great, because I never sort of expected I'd have my own DVD out, and when I did, it was a case of, yeah, it feels like I've actually done something really good here. And it was like January, February time when I released this. And yeah, a lot of people bought it, like I said, and I'm quite proud of that to be to this day, to be honest. I don't really want to have a look at it, because I'll probably look horrendous. But yeah, it did really well, and it's maybe something I would do again, release something on DVD, who knows. Yeah, it's mainly all positives about 2018, because there's nothing bad that happened. It was all, well, there was in ways, but it was sort of a really good year in a way of a sense of achievement, if you like. Yes, certain performances didn't go the best, but it did go really well, and it was the first time I performed publicly. I never believed I'd be doing my own concert outside of school, and just the way I felt afterwards was just, I felt so happy, and just trying to exude happiness from the audience, and it's just, you can't exactly take it all in, to be fair, especially at the end when everyone's joining in, and that's what you wanted, that's your aim for the show. But it's not as if something ever thought would actually happen. It's so weird how it all works. But I'm more than grateful for all the opportunities I've been given so far. 2018 was a year that was really unpredictable, but really good at the same time. And it was a good representation of how things have progressed from 2016, for example. Because I was dancing like R.A.O., whatever it was, back in like Yeah, 7 out of 8. I did not think that that would end up leading to me performing my own concert in 2018 November. And it was the thing that really was really good for me is that I'd done 2 charity events that year, and I managed to raise a substantial amount of money for Marie Curie. Obviously, that's a special charity to me and my family, and many other people as well. And that's what I was really proud of, managed to raise all that money for the charity. And it's just great to give someone back like that. But, except to say, after the concert, I was very happy I had that break. I was just, I was more than ready for Christmas holidays to begin, put it that way. And obviously, I raised for the documentary in early 2019. And then, that's where that era sort of came to an end, the Party on the Dance Floor era. Nothing could have predicted me for how 2019 went. Out of all the years I've been doing this, this was by far, hands down, the best. From releasing my own album, to releasing a song, to doing the concert, to doing Newcastle Pride. Some of the opportunities I was given in 2019 were so surreal, and it's just, it hasn't even sunk in probably I don't think yet. And yeah, I'll never ever forget that how that year went. And I thought 2018 was good, but yeah, it was just 2019 topped it all off completely.